Final review then for the week. Let's talk about Ferrari Race to Immortality, which is actually. Do you know this is like the third Formula One documentary we've had this year?
That's a lot.
Did you even know that?
Because I did not. I thought it was Senna years ago, and no other examples.
Well, this year we've gone through McLaren and Williams, and now we're at Ferrari. So yeah, okay. So this is directed by Darrell Goodrich, and this is basically not so much the background of Ferrari. We do get that sort of early on, like a very brief truncated version of that. But it is the rise of Enzo Ferrari. It's filmed in that brilliant Senna-like style, in that Asif Kapadia-like style of we'll never use talking heads. It is all
poor David Byrne.
Okay, no. Okay, sorry. Yeah, it's all voices. It's all archival footage, and it's all tremendous editing. And what you get is it looks at the rivalries that emerged, the relationships that he had with his racers. I almost said players then, with his racers, the relationships he had with friends and with relationships off screen, off the track. And well, yeah, I mean, story Ferrari. Here's a clip.
It was an era of great glamour and great risk. These men went out to drive these red cars, not knowing whether they would come back alive.
When it came to running drivers, Ferrari's approach was the more pressure you put on them, the faster they will go.
Well, they were rather like fighter pilots. Or gladiators, I suppose.
So this does focus quite heavily as well on the relationship between Peter Collins and Mike Hawthorne, who were the British racers who joined Ferrari in, I think, the 50s, I think. And they were sort of the poster boys for a while, but they were also best friends. And there's a really intriguing way of going into this story in which they focus on these two friends and how Ferrari himself liked to foster animosity and competitiveness between his drivers. And so, like, he could only have four available at one time, but he had five drivers. So someone always had to sit it out. And these two being so friendly kind of screwed him a little. And he hated the fact, and he didn't know until after he'd hired them that they were as chummy as they were. And the relationship is really sweet and really interesting and actually something to actually enjoy watching unfold on screen. The depiction of Ferrari himself, thankfully, doesn't shy away from his nastier elements, because he was a hard-edged guy who really had no interest outside of racing. And we get him on tape admitting as much. Him actually saying, "I don't have a life outside of driving. I wouldn't want one." And that's absolutely fair enough. It doesn't shy away from, you know, depicting anyone in negative light. It doesn't shy away from depicting the nastier side of racing either. There's a lot of footage in here that is absolutely harrowing to watch. Just accidents and things like that where they happen to have been caught on camera. In a time when racing wasn't really a televised sport, but they happen to have footage of these open-top racing cars flipping over and bodies just being absolutely snapped in half and guys being thrown hundreds of feet across through the air. And it's absolutely mortifying at times, and yet at the same time absolutely exhilarating. It is a brilliant encapsulation of what it must have been like to be in that sport at that time, and you can actually see why it fascinates so many people in this. Surprisingly, we don't actually get more works of narrative fiction set in the racing world, actually, because you watch something like this and think there is
we just get a lot of like biopics, don't we?
Yeah, I mean, other than a biopic, because we're getting a Ferrari one from Michael Mann, aren't we? Is that still happening?
Christian Bale, I believe that's still
did
happening.
Did he drop out or did he not? I don't know.
I think he'll have to, like... I need to see a picture of Enzo Ferrari, really.
He's a large Italian man.
Well, that's all right, then. I guess, yeah. Like, you work your way up to Dick Cheney.
And then when you're on the way back down, weight-wise, you stop at Enzo Ferrari about halfway. Yeah, okay, that's
it, yeah.
On screen.